Hey there, I'm Alan Matthews from Classical Guitar Shed, and in this video we're going to be talking about the phenomenon of practicing sounding great at home and then going to a lesson or playing for somebody else and all of a sudden it just goes to pieces. And how confusing is that? Because it sounds so good at home. That's what we're going to talk about in just a second. If you enjoy this, please do subscribe to this channel and we'll do it again sometime. So the problem is, and this is so common, that we sound bad whenever we play in our lessons, that we show up and everything just goes to pieces. And I don't know why I'm missing that. I never miss it at home. I play for somebody and I mess up in places that I've never messed up before. And how bizarre. But actually, here's what's happening. Chances are, what you're thinking about at home is your 20th repetition. You play that thing, and you've already played it 20 times, and so of course the 20th one is just sounding so good. And then you compare that to your very first run at your lesson or when you play for people. If you want to get a good, realistic picture of how you're playing at home, turn on your video camera before you even pick up the guitar, sit down, pick up the guitar, and play your piece and see what it sounds like first run. Keep going, can't go back and catch things, no fixing mistakes, no nothing like that. But instead, just get a realistic picture of, I sit down and play cold, this is what it sounds like. Chances are it will sound really similar to the way that you sound in lessons. So this is a really common thing. We compare our best to our, we compare our 20th run to our first run in a lesson. And so then we're thinking that we're at this level when actually our cold start is way down here. So what is the answer then? The answer is to recognize this and then practice so that you have an absolute strategy of how to play things. What's my fingering on my left hand? What's my fingering in my right hand? How do I play? What's my physiology when I'm playing? Am I tense and relaxed? Granted, in lessons there might be a little bit of anxiety or playing for people, but that's actually a small part of it. And if we're really prepared for that first run in at home in our practice room, then chances are we'll be much better so in front of people, be it our teacher or somebody else that we're playing for. So super preparation. Do I know the music? Can I play it cleanly just out of the gates? And how do I do that? What are my string crossings? How do I hold my hand? Everything. If we can do that, then we can sit down and have a much better chance of just getting something well out of the gate, or at least better, right? So this is the strategy, is just be better prepared and be realistic in practice of what is actually happening. Another way to test this in practice is to come back to things when you've been practicing something else and record them, video them, and then watch them back. So if you've been practicing your scales, then go forward and then practice your piece and just play your piece for the camera one time. And see how it goes. Since you've not been practicing that particular piece a bunch of times, come to it, you're warmed up, but it's still the first time that you're playing it that day or in a while. So I hope you've enjoyed this little foray into that phenomenon that we all experience or have experienced if we've taken lessons or played for other people and wondered why it doesn't sound the same as it does at home. All right, please subscribe to this channel if you haven't, and thank you so much for watching. Take care.